Hello everybody. So I wanted to share with you one idea that I thought about it. So this imitation for microgreen. So we have here, this is hydroponic. And hydroponic here, you don't need to use media, just the water. You have the root coming out and fill in the water here. But this is not our topic. Our topic is a microgreen. So as we see here, the microgreen actually doing great in this type of tray. This tray, it's actually has two parts, the net part, as you see here, and the bottom part. The bottom part, you can fill it with water, whereas the net part, it holds the plants and stable them. And through this net, when germination happened, so the root will go through and the plants will attach itself in and will absorb the water. This is a good one for school, because when you have microgreen, you need to water it every day. But if you have a weekend and you are going to your weekend, you don't want like the plants die over the weekend. So you can add extra water and they will can survive. So this one has 3 weeks old tray and is growing well. I have it over long weekend and even some days I don't come to school, like 4 days in a row, and still growing, nothing happened. So as you see here, and the plants in the top, so you can just like pull one plant and you have the plants with roots here. So it is great one, but sometimes you would like to have something for the student to take home. And if you go and do it at home, you don't want to have this big amount of microgreen. You need something smaller. So what we do in this situation, I came up with ideas. I found some folks on YouTube use this tray by making hole in the tray, just one or two, and have this part underneath which full with water, and have a mat. So they're using this type of hem mat. For me, I'm not doing that. I'm not using the mat. In case if you cannot access to buy the mat, you can use a screen. So I will imitate the same idea as this one, but I will make using this type of food container that we throw away. So we're going to use a screen, this kind of like a window screen, and we're going to add it to our cover here. We're going to cut this frame or cover and make it a frame. Then we're going to glue this part here and put it down here. So we will have enough space to add water at the bottom, and our seed will grow on the screen itself. It's the same idea as this one. So it's homemade and cheaper. Even you can buy this, like five of them, you can buy it for $20 on Amazon, but this one will cost us maybe like $1 or so, if you have the tools. So, let's do it together. You need the cover. You need the tray itself. And you're going to need a scissor. Or for my situation here, I can use the hard tool to cut. So let's do that. So I'm going to cut it, so I'll put it upside down in. That's it. After that, we need to get our screen. So we'll do like a bigger size, like cover it. We need to make sure that the screen is covered totally, the cover tray, and we're going to cut. So we have those paper clips. So take your net, let's clip it. Okay, now we need to glue. Just make it tighter a bit. Okay, you are. Then this side as well. Here. You can have it this way if you would like and keep it if you don't have a glue. But for my reason, I have some glue, so I'm going to glue it. Okay, I'm gluing this side as well. Then the other side. Some people use like screw nails. Add more glue. That's it. So now you need to wait a little bit. It will dry. After it dry, we're going to take the clips out and cut the extra amount that we don't want. So this is your now tray, resemble this one in a smaller scale. So if you'd like to have experiment, I bought like those tray for the classroom first, and the student not coming to classroom because of the COVID-19. So I need to buy a kit to send it home. So I decide instead I buy those. It would be expensive to send to home. It will be like around like $7 each, and this will be expensive to send. So I bought around like 150 of those food container from Amazon. Cost like $60. So each one costs like $0.50 almost, and the net you can buy it like cost you like 50 cents. So the container itself with the wax everything costs you like 150 cent. So this is a good one. It's a smaller scale. It requires less space for the students and also require less seeds to use. So what I'm using, I bought those seeds. So I did a project on donor choose, and the project was half funded by the one of the big company like National Grids, and the other half is funded by parents. So with like $500, I get $250 from the parents school and the other $250 from the company. And the project funded and bought the stuff, but after that realized nobody comes, so I start to buy those the stuff by my own, which is like the food container and so on, and I found I would like to share it with you. So usually it's enough to have half spoon, if you like, for this tray, or one 3/4 of a spoon of seeds. This is scale. You can buy them bulk, like it's $15. And the germination is very good. As you see, germination is very good and really yield well. So let's take this stuff away. You are. Now we just cut the pieces that we don't need. here. Excellent, flat, tight. You can just put it here. So before we put the seed on, you need to wait it, because if you put the seed will run around and won't the seed to run around, right? So if you wet it, the seed will not run around. So let's wet it. It's wet. Just take your spoon. Take 3/4. And you're going to start, like, try to make sure it's not clump. And put in the area that has opening. Okay. That's it. Make sure there's no clump here, because if it's clump, it will rotten. You won't want to rotten. And well, and keep it in a space that is dark, and put something heavier on it. So maybe take another tray and put it on top of it. That's it. And every day you can spray for like 3 times a day for 3 days, and you start to get similar result as the one that I show you there. You're going to get sprouting, and after that 2 weeks will grow this way as well. Usually we use this hemp mat, so we are using those mats. They are nice, they grow well, but you need to water every day, twice or once a day, to yield the same amount. But with this one, you don't need to buy the mat, and you can have it water for a whole weekend or long weekend even, and you don't worry that they will die over the long weekend. I hope that you like the project. Let me know if it's work with you. I still do some experiment with it, and see how it will work. Most important is tight, so the stuff spread all over equally. It's not like dent back and forth. And let's see more project. So I left for almost 10 days or 12 days without watering them. I left the water bottom, the water almost finished. Then I add more water and they grow back again. As well as you see here, this one also, they grow well. Just like because they start wilted when they didn't have enough water, and as you see the root, it's doing great. I add more water, so it will grow back again as supposed to. You can have it for like 10 days without adding water, because the water will be here, the mesh net working well. As you see, they have already went through the mesh net, so here one of them is a nice root. So if I take one of those, lift it up, it will come up nicely. So this is a good way. Actually, it's a success. I didn't add too much seed here. I had a lot of seed here, more than this one. Let me know your comment and your thought. Thank you.
Okay, let me see.